स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर अंजलि राहाटगांवकर, प्रोफेसर एंड हेड एट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ साइंस, नागपुर. गाइस, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिक सिंथेसिस, एंड दैट इज द रेट्रोसिंथेटिक एनालिसिस. सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ रेट्रोसिंथेटिक एनालिसिस? Retrosynthetic analysis is an imaginative process in which the target molecule is disconnected into the less complex structures.
Means the
next generation of the target molecules can be synthesized from the target molecule.
You can repeat this procedure,
or this procedure is repeated down to the simple, easily available starting material or the compounds.
Now, methodical
breaking apart from the target material, which is leading to the more simpler structures that can be prepared by the known conceivable reactions. And that is the basis of heterosynthetic analysis.
Now, the application of
this procedure, it requires a basic knowledge of the organic chemistry, especially the mechanistic approach, the mechanism of various organic reactions, and some basic knowledge regarding the charged species. For example, the nucleophilicity of the molecule, electrophiles, etc., etc.
Now, where
apart from the retrosynthetic analysis, the one more aspect has been involved over here. Now, the first thing is when you cut the molecule into number of fragments, and those fragments we can write down on the paper. So this is a total imaginative process. Now
when we
now this is the reverse way of thinking, that the idea is conceived in the mind and we can write down on the paper, and from target molecule we can reach to the starting material. Another, now we have to write down the synthesis also, because whatever we have written on the paper, whatever imaginary things we have decided on the paper, that has to be realized in the laboratory. So
whatever molecule
we have designed on the paper with the help of retrosynthetic analysis, that can be synthesized in the laboratory.
The synthesis should be real. And the sequence, of course, it is
there are certain rules and regulations we will discuss later on when we go to various strategies. But the very basic thing is, whenever we apply the retrosynthetic analysis, when we have a target molecule, so we cut that molecule into the simpler target molecules or simpler fragments, so that you can get the final the most simplest
molecule, that is also known as
a starting material. Now this starting material you have to use for the second step of this retrosynthetic analysis, and this is the synthesis part. So by considering the starting material, which was the end of the retrosynthetic analysis, from target molecule to the starting material. Now in that case, what I told you earlier, that by considering the starting material, that starting material also very important. It should be easily available, it should be readily available, or it should be commercially feasible molecule. So what is the role of organic scientist over here? The organic scientist has to decide such a pathway that he or she should select the proper starting material for the synthesis.
The second thing is
it should be cheap.
It should be cost effective. And the third thing
is the latest aspect which has been considered over here, that is considering with the green chemistry concept. So with the help of these three principles, the organic scientist has to select a proper starting material for the synthesis. Now let us move to the second aspect, that is some basic terminologies are involved in the retrosynthetic analysis. Now here the first terminology I can say that is the target molecule. So in the retrosynthetic analysis, we have to consider this target molecule. That is your first term, that molecule which is to be synthesized.
Now then, what is the
second terminology, that is a retrosynthetic analysis? Of course, the process which is mentally breaking down into the simpler material or simpler target molecule, or you can say the
starting
material. Then the third is whenever we write down any reaction, we usually draw a reaction where the reactants and the products. So in between the reactant and products, we draw a simple arrow, a single headed arrow. Here we have a double headed arrow. The importance of this double headed arrow is that it represents the direction of your synthesis.
It represents the reverse,
that your synthetic approach is reversed.
Means from initially we write down the reactants
to products. But here we have to write the product first, and the product you can draw the first target molecule, then the second target molecule, then the third target molecule, and finally we have
to simplify the
what we can say the starting material.
So this is a very
important aspect in the retrosynthesis
by using proper
symbols. All right, then moving to the next terminology, that is the disconnection. Now this is again the imaginary cleavage of the bond corresponding to the reverse of the real reaction. So one by one we will discuss all these points. Then the next point is the synthon, where this is a idealized fragments which are resulting from the breaking of the target material.
All right,
and usually these synthons are the charged species.
They are
nucleophiles and the electrophiles. So this is a very important point to be noted over here. And the next terminology is equally
important, and that is nothing
but the synthetic equivalence. Now, what is the meaning of synthetic equivalents? They are the neutral species of the synthons.
Means from the synthons, you have to derive
the neutral species which can be used as a starting material in the synthesis.
So this is a very
important point where when we reach up to the synthetic equivalents,
Then now
we are ready for the synthesis in the laboratory.
So the journey from
target material to the starting point, a brief discussion we have done over here, and with the help of starting material, the second step of the retrosynthetic analysis will start. Now you consider that starting material as a starting materials, that is a synthetic equivalence, and by using various reagents.
The last point
is the reagent. Now what is the reagent? Reagent that is also a real chemical which can be easily
available in the market, commercially available. So with the help
of starting material and the reagents, you can start the synthesize, and you can with the help of the mechanistic approach or with the help of some knowledge, you can easily reach to the target molecule. So this is how you have to design the retrosynthetic analysis, and you can reach the, with the help of synthesis again, you can reach the target molecule. So both way, whatever procedure you, whatever operations you have done in the retrosynthetic analysis in the first part, that thought process or that procedure can be
verified
or justified in the next part, that is a synthesis of the target material. So dear students, let us start the some terminologies of the retrosynthesis.
So we have discussed the various terminologies in the retrosynthetic analysis. Now let us see the one by one what we have discussed earlier. Now in the retrosynthetic analysis, it is divided into, as we have I have already told you, that it is divided into two portions, that so the two portions are the analysis and the synthesis. All right. So routine for the for designing a synthesis, that we have to see. So the, that is a routine, what routinely we have to do for designing a synthesis. So basically there are two parts. One part is, like I can show you the retrosynthetic analysis, where we have two parts. The one part is the analysis, and the another part is the synthesis. All right. Now in the analysis, what are the necessary things to follow? Let us see one by one. Now the first, as we know, that recognize the functional group. Recognize the functional group. So there can be many groups also. Okay. So functional group or groups in the target molecule, and so once you recognized the how many functional groups are present in the target molecule, then you try to disconnect the target molecule into simpler fragments. Disconnect the target, so I am writing for target molecule as a TM. Okay, by such a method, that you should get a reliable fragments or reliable reaction. Now here I will focus later on, but let me first add the third parameter, that is repeat the reaction, the necessary fragmentation or disconnection. Till you get the simpler material, or another way you can say that there might be a starting material. Now let me explain these 3 points first. That as we know that the retrosynthetic analysis, it has two parts. One part is the analysis part, the another part is the synthesis part. Now in the analysis part, what we have to judge or what we have to see first, just see the target material, that is the molecule which is given to you. Okay, so try to examine, try to observe that molecule and find out the observing a molecule means you have to locate the reaction centers, you have to locate the various properties, like whether there are any electron withdrawing groups which are attached to the molecules or to the molecule, or any electron donating groups are there. Some groups are ortho para directors, some groups are meta directors. So these are the various parameters which are you must know regarding the molecule. All right. So such functional groups, they are having meta directing effect. Some functional groups may have the ortho para directing effects likewise. So identify such functional groups in the target molecule and then disconnect that target molecule in a simpler fragments so that you will get the starting material. You can reach to the starting material. If you don't get the starting material, a simpler starting material, then again try to continue, repeat the same procedure and cut down that particular molecule into the simpler one. Now what is the meaning of simpler one? As I told you that simpler ones means we have to reach up to the starting material, and that starting material should be readily available in the market. Commercially it should be available. So that is the agenda of the getting starting material of the molecule. All right, then the next part is the synthesis. So I can give this as a first part of the retrosynthetic analysis, and this will be your second part. Now again there are 2 points which are very important in the synthesis. Now right, so you have already a plan which is on the paper when you carry out the retrosynthetic analysis. So you have already a plan with you, that you have a target material, you have written the plan. In this way you can you cut down the fragments and finally you achieve the starting material. Now here in the synthesis, the reverse is the process. From the starting material you reach to the target molecule. So again write down the reaction. So write out the plan accordingly. Plan according to analysis. According to analysis. Now this particular step I can explain by quoting some good example. So for the time being you just try to understand what I am writing over here. Write out the plan according to the analysis. Means whatever analysis you have done, your plan should be go parallel with the analysis. You cannot go currently. Your plan should not be different from whatever the analysis you have done. That is very important. It means that whatever steps you have considered in the analysis, those steps should be covered in the synthesis. This is the actual meaning of the writing out the plan according to the analysis and then adding the reagents accordingly. Adding the starting material and the reagents. Starting material and the reagents. All right, and the reagents. So this is the first part you have to remember. Now, again, if sometimes the reaction doesn't work in the laboratory, so what is the idea behind that? Your whatever analysis you have done in the retrosynthetic part, it should be executed in the laboratory. Means whatever you have done virtually on the paper, that reaction should be carried out in the laboratory. That is the ideal plan. Alright, but sometimes it doesn't work. If it doesn't work, then modify the plan. So you have a liberty to modify the plan also. The only thing is you should achieve the target material. You should achieve the because of unexpected parameters, unexpected reason. Now those unexpected reason can be with the chemoselectivity, or we can say that there is another aspect, that is a stereochemical aspects. All right. So couple of parameters I have discussed. There might be some more parameters also, like the strength of the molecule, etc., etc. So sometimes the reaction doesn't go whatever we are expecting. So in that case, you can have a liberty to modify the plan, but the final result should be your target material. All right. So this is how you have to conduct the retrosynthetic analysis. So the analysis is only analysis part is the halfway done. So you have to conduct the first part, second part also, that is the synthesis. So whatever strategy you have decided over here, it should be executed in the laboratory, and synthesis part is a very, very important. The second part very much important in the retrosynthetic analysis. So you can justify your retrosynthetic analysis by having the synthesis of the target material in the laboratory. So I hope you understand up to this level, and in the next lecture we'll try to explain some good example. Then you can easily understand the analysis part and the synthesis part of the retrosynthetic analysis. Goodbye.